last year in the upfront, we actually made a pledge to the industry to deploy addressability in our premium content environments on a national level in 52 million homes. As of second quarter, we've reached 55 million households addressably. So we are truly talking about precision targeting at scale. It's important because it solidifies our commitment to audience-based targeting for advertisers and our holding company partners to deploy precision targeting at scale and personalization. The addressable effort is actually just one building block that we are committed to in order to get us one step closer to truly cross-screen targeting. So the ability to identify a pre-qualified audience on a unique basis, deduplicated across the ecosystem. We have our data-driven linear products, linear and digital. We have had our legacy Audience Now product, and this actually is, again, digitizing the television experience. And so the ultimate holy grail will be for us to actually be able to sync all of that and find audiences across the Warner footprint.
Now, for marketers who may not be aware of what addressable advertising is, what can you tell them about its value for brands?
Yes, absolutely. So we've been in this space for quite some time. There's been a significant amount of adoption over the years in terms of the data-driven products. And primarily on a scale, that was really one-to-many targeting. So we were able to migrate from broad-based age, gender, demographics across the portfolio to what we call one-to-many targeting. Addressability now allows us to target a specific household. Addressability now allows us to target a specific household. So it actually just makes that personalization and targetability that much more valuable for our clients. We have so many partners and so many agency holdco relationships, and they've invested very heavily in their own data that they are bringing to market, and clients over the years with mining their own CRM data, that the ability now to take this from a one-to-one experience to from a one-to-many experience to a one-to-one targeting level is phenomenal. So really, we know from our experience that data-driven linear absolutely is effective. We've done hundreds of case studies on it, and now we're really looking forward to proving the efficacy of addressable.
Yeah, and that brings me to my final question about measurement. And there's been a lot of discussion lately about developing an alternate currency and what's the best way to measure audiences. So how does addressable fit into these discussions?
Yeah, that's an excellent question. First things first, actually, alternate currencies, they're not new to us. With our effort over the last 6-7 years in the advanced space, we have been guaranteeing on alternate currencies for many years and numerous data sets. So really the whole effort is how do we bring that to scale now that there's so many alternatives and there are so many vendors out there? You have heard probably that Warner has made a vested interest in testing alternative measurement vendors. We are doing that in second quarter and potentially thereafter. And addressable will be the next iteration of that. We first need to look at the scalability of the alternate measurement partners on a pure national level and then dive deep into addressable. So it's a couple different phases, but we actually have signed on Comscore as one of our vendors to do a beta to measure addressable in third quarter for us. So we actually have that out in market as an opportunity for our agencies.